The Babysitter, Killer Queen is here, but critics aren't loving the sequel. The film, a follow to 2017's The Babysitter, began streaming on Netflix Thursday, and as reviews roll in, things aren't looking very positive. The original film was an underrated gory horror comedy about 12-year-old Cole, Judah Lewis, being tapped for sacrifice by his babysitter's satanic death cult. The sequel is a revisit, with Cole now in high school dealing with the aftermath, as well as hormones. During a weekend getaway with his best friend, Emily Allen Lind, things go awry when cult members return and a mysterious new girl, Jenna Ortega, enters the picture. Though both films were made under the same direction of director McGee, Charlie's Angels, the results proved disappointingly different in the eyes of reviewers, with some critics noting Killer Queen is just not as fresh and fun as the original. On Rotten Tomatoes, the film has a 29% tomatometer score and a 78% audience score as of Friday at 11:30 a.m. ET. Here are more excerpts from critics. There's far too much emphasis on uninspired comic riffing from subsidiary characters. Further excesses include over dependence on soundtracking the most obvious classic pop hits. Too many on the nose verbal references to prior movies. An overdose of jokey on-screen text graphics. And a badly misplaced faith that you can't possibly have enough cartoonish violence or sophomoric sexual humor. The final taste of cilantro in this cynical cake comes with a late dash of sentimentality, all the more bogus for being one time the filmmakers do not appear to be joking. As before, a brief coda suggests a potential next Babysitter chapter, but in the great tradition of Book of Shadows, Blair Witch 2, this is the eagerly awaited sequel that ends up drastically reducing any desire for another. It's not often Netflix releases sequels to its movies, and it may have been better if The Babysitter had been left without a follow-up. The Babysitter, Killer Queen is junk food entertainment at its most mediocre, delivering barely enough blood and fun without anything truly memorable, making the story of a horror film more complicated in. The sequel isn't a guarantee of success, and in the case of The Babysitter, Killer Queen, it largely distracts from the silly, bloody fun that made the original so entertaining. Gory horror comedies with half-baked plots can actually be quite entertaining if they are at least well shot and well written. This sequel to the borderline decent 2017 Netflix original The Babysitter is neither of these things. It's essentially a replay of the first, to the point that the action stops at one moment so the words "what the expletive" again can appear on the screen. Embarrassing. Killer Queen essentially reiterates the same plot as the original, but junks it up with dumb over-stylized flashbacks, cutaway gag sequences, dopey supporting characters, and an earnest, emo backstory subplot that's like finding a stag beetle in your ice cream. There's no reason this thing should be 101 minutes. No reason. It's weird to think that McGee could be assembling some invigoratingly glossy big, budget action fodder, but instead is enforcing some weird, phony soundstage / CG visual aesthetic to a horror comedy that could really use some more devilishness and a little less diddle farting. Sick. Contributing, Brian Truett Moore, Netflix encourages subscribers to watch cuties after online. Backlash, cancel Netflix drama more. Virtual friendship is kind of terrifying in Will Wheaton's new horror movie Rent, a pal. Thank you.